she is working with various funded projects and consultancies. She is a member of many professional bodies. She has published 50 plus research papers in various reputed journals and conferences. She is an editorial and advisory board member of many journals and reviewed many papers for Scopus and various reputed journals. She is a member of Transportation Research Board. Also, she is a member of BOSIT, University of Mumbai. She has written 5+ books in renowned publications for different subjects of University of Mumbai. So I request Dr. Vaishali Khannar Madam to share her views. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. First, I would like to thank Konkan Gyanpith College of Engineering Management, Principal Sir and HOD for organizing such a orientation program for revised 2009 syllabus scheme for the subject of Paradigms and Computer Programming Fundamentals, and related to it, the lab that is Computer Programming Paradigms Lab. So basically, if you would have seen, okay, this is the scheme C, as Grande sir told, okay, in 2012, the syllabus was been revised. It was a credit-based system syllabus, which was a scheme A. Then 2016, the syllabus was again been revised, which was a choice-based. And now it is a 2019, as per AICT model curriculum, the syllabus has been revised, which is a scheme C. So as per interaction with the stakeholders in Father Agnel meeting and other meetings, so basically, as per the industry requirement, the whatever the subjects are been required by the industry are the advanced topics, and related to that, the concepts has to be there. So here, if you will see in this particular semester, 3 syllabus of the scheme, we have come up with basically the mini project concept. Then we have come up with the self-learning concept, which is available in each and every theory subject. And there is a skill-based lab, which has been required for students. So their skills will be developed. So in the semester 3, there is a Java skill-based lab. In semester 4, there is a Python skill-based lab. So according to that, the syllabus has been designed. So the students will be skilled, and the project-based learning concept has been implemented by using a mini project, which has been added into semester 3 and semester 4, plus in the third year, semester 5 and semester 6. And the final year will be the major project of semester 7 and semester 8. Thus, compared to this particular subject, so here in this case, whatever is the subject has been, the team members will explain you the details about that particular module wise and the subject wise. So here in this case, this subject concept is that the student should aware about the concepts for the programming. So the programming can be any of the tool. So if the concepts are clear, the language can be anything. So here the students with the concepts, they will learn the different languages. So you can have basically there will be Java also, C++ also, Prolog also, Haskell also. So any of the language which can be used if the concepts are being clear and they can, it can be implemented. So the details will be explained into this particular syllabus. So here in this, whatever is the main thing, there is whatever is the syllabus, it is consisting of the logic and the functional programming. So functional programming is deal with it is a mathematical functions has to be used. And according to that, if I want to develop it for using a programming language, simple Java or C++ or C, I require to apply a logic for it. So for that purpose, there is a called as a Haskell programming language, which supports a full functional programming language for it. And according to that, the concepts the students will understand, there is more demand for the jobs for functional programming. The remaining part, I think, so the team members will explain you in detail. So thanks a lot for inviting me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for providing the insights about the subject. Now that you have given us the opportunity to explain about the syllabus, the agenda for the orientation is as follows. We will be first explaining you the paradigms and computer programming fundamentals. Module wise, we'll cover the syllabus coverage and evaluation scheme. Then we'll talk about computer programming paradigms laboratory. Module wise, there we will be also covering the syllabus and the evaluation mechanism. We will talk about e-content generation and question answers. I know being a new subject, there would be definitely a lot of questions related to logistics, how to conduct things, what will be there in what particular module, etc., etc. We will give you time for discussing all those questions, and we definitely will try to answer each and every question that all of you have in your mind. Now, to begin with, before we go to the actual module-wise syllabus, I will tell you about the teaching scheme for the subject. So first, we are talking about ITC 305, which is Paradigms and Computer Programming Fundamentals. This has 3 hours of theory, and credits assigned to it is 3. Then, as far as the evaluation is of the subject is concerned, we have internal test of 20 marks, another internal test of 20 marks. The average is average of these two tests will be taken up, and the end semester examination of 80 marks is going to be there. So totally the examination evaluation is through 100 marks. Now we'll first look at the course objectives. The course objective for the subjects are, first to introduce various programming paradigms and the basic constructs and underlying any programming language. The second objective is to understand the data abstraction and object orientation. Third objective is to introduce the basic concept of declarative programming paradigms through functional and logical programming. Fourth is to design solutions using declarative programming paradigms.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Through functional and logical programming. Hello. My voice is audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I thought there's some problem because the network is not good today in my area. Please don't mind if you are getting a break in the voice, and please let me know so that I can reiterate whatever is going on. The course objectives we were discussing, we were reached up to the fourth objective, to design solutions using declarative programming paradigms through functional and logic programming. The fifth course objective is to introduce the concept of concurrent program execution. The sixth and the last objective is to be able to understand use of scripting language for different problem domains. To have these objectives reached, the course outcomes, once these objectives are achieved, the course outcomes for the subject that are proposed are, the first outcome is understand and compare different programming paradigms, understand the object-oriented constructs and use them in program design, understand the concept of declarative programming paradigm through functional and logical programming, design and develop programs based on declarative programming paradigm using functional and or logical programming. Fifth course of outcome is understand the role of concurrency in parallel and distributed programming. The last objective is understand different application domains for using scripting language. So thus, these six outcomes evaluated, we have mapped these outcomes to the levels of Bloom's taxonomy, and the course objective 1, 2, 3, and 6 are mapped to level 1. Course objective outcome 1, 2, 3, and 6 also mapped to level 2. Course outcome 4 is mapped to level 5 and level 6. How this is exactly will be more elaborated during the discussion of module-wise syllabus contents and the references. So now we will look at each module, what is the content of that module, what generally should be covered in that particular module, including number of teaching hours we have assigned, how a faculty, or what kind of reference material this particular chapter requires to be used. And then after discussing all of these per module, we will go to the discussion for the evaluation of the particular of the subject. Okay, so I will start off with the discussion of module one, which is introduction to programming paradigms and core language design issues. As you can see, this particular module is mapped to level one and level two of Bloom's taxonomy as far as the evaluation is concerned. That is, we expect that student would be evaluated based on their abilities to remember and understand the concepts. So this particular module is mostly the concept-based module, wherein the evaluation will be focused more on learning the basic underlying concept. Okay, the course outcome of the module is to understand and compare different programming paradigms. So basically, here a faculty should make student aware of the existence of different programming paradigms, because we have thought when this particular module is being taught to the student already knows only one programming language. So we are expecting them to only know the C programming language that is covered in the second semester. So they already are aware about the structured programming way of C programming to write the programs, but other programming paradigms they are not aware of. So here the emphasis of the staff member should first introduce student the idea of programming paradigms, or why programming paradigms are required, how they relate to different kinds of solutions. And then also the module is going to cover certain core language design issues which are generally used by all the different kinds of programming paradigms. So this module is divided into two parts. We are here assigned two theory hours for introducing different programming. So here we have assigned two teaching hours for introducing different programming paradigms to the students, wherein you might feel that within 2 hours how you can deal the array of different programming paradigms. But this is a very brief introduction to every paradigm and its features, so that student will understand the underlying content of the whole syllabus, because all the 5 modules which are going to come after this module, they are dependent on a particular kind of paradigm. So the student should have an idea about the paradigm, how exactly that paradigm is used, where exactly that paradigm used. That is the basis for this particular sub part of the module. The second sub part of the module, that is the core language design issues or basic language design issues, is where we have to focus, and we have to actually invest 8 long teaching hours for conveying to the student all these basic concepts, which will be useful for us in taking further every module. Because whenever we are dealing with a particular module, a particular paradigm, during that particular period, these concepts are going to come handy for us later on. Okay, as far as there were certain questions prior to this meeting directly directed to me, people were skeptical about what sort of programming language to be used over here for this particular module. I insist that there is no need of using a particular programming language for teaching all these concepts. You can use pseudocode, or you may use certain kind of small research programming languages like ML or something like Racket if you want to, but there is no insistence on that. You will find such research languages in ScottML Programming Language Paradigms 3rd edition book. There is no insistence on using any particular programming language while discussing all these concepts, but you will require here and there, in order that student understands the concept, to give certain examples of syntactic information of the programming language that students are aware of, or rather you can use some syntax to explain the concepts. but that syntax is not compulsory as such. So it depends.